If we think miracles, prophecies are enough, we should all follow Dajjal. Why? Because he's going to give you, in front of your very eyes, things that supposedly look dead come back to life. He's going to command the sky to rain and it's going to look like it's raining. He is going to do things which is going to confuse the hell out of you. Right? Isa alayhi salam, whatever he did, we did it with Allah's permission. Dajjal is going to claim he's doing it by himself. So why are we not going to follow Dajjal? Because he's doing miracles, and we also have the miracles of the Prophet, but he's doing miracles. What's the difference? The difference is the theology. What is his theology? Who's God? He's God. The theology of the Prophet ﷺ is that Allah is worthy of worship. It doesn't matter if a man comes like him and says, here's a miracle, here's a miracle, here's a prediction, here's this. If the fundamental theology is false, we don't care if it's a million miracles. So we will believe in the Prophet ﷺ even if he didn't come with any prophecies because of his theology. But if he comes with prophecies, they only add. They only add to the proof of prophethood. What's interesting in the world today is that the new atheist movement, this liberal, atheistic, humanistic movement which is sweeping the Western world, they are priming the world to accept, without them understanding what they're doing, the message of the person on the previous slide. Him. Why? Because what is their message? Firstly, rejection. Rejection of who? Rejection of God and religions. Two, what's their other message? Materialism. What's Dajjal's main thing? Who's going to be attracted to him? People who are affected by materialism. And materialism is fueled by Darwinism, atheism, feminism, liberalism, humanism. These ideas, they're about progress being better. Whenever they talk about why the Western world is supposedly better, when they make the arguments about the Western world, and of course we're not saying East versus West and clash of civilization, anything like that. What we're saying is that their argument is, look at us, look at their technology we have, look at the money we have, right? So fueling materialism, rejecting God, rejecting religions, right? Making the blasphemous, the sacred unsacred, right? Making it so it is blasphemy in the sense of Aleister Crowley, normalizing swearing at God. Or like, for example, one of the blasphemous things which was out maybe 30 years ago is the life of Brian, right? In which they were mocking Jesus, they were mocking Isa alayhi salam. This types of normalizing this type of bad insults towards God and his messenger, whether it's Islam, Christianity, Judaism, doesn't matter. This is what they do. The third thing is, apart from rejection of God and rejecting the messengers and materialism, the third unholy trinity here is their focus on empiricism. We will only see what we believe. We will only believe something we can see. We want the miracle now. We don't want to believe, oh God, we can't see God. I want to see God. This unholy trinity of rejection of traditional belief in God, increase in materialism, which is the fodder that Dajjal needs to attract people, and the focus on empiricism. If they want a physical God, that's what Dajjal's going to be. And if you look at Surah Kahf, that we're supposed to read in protection for the Dajjal, look at the messages in that surah. One of the messages, in fact, many of the messages, they exactly correlate with a counter to the new atheist sort of priming. Because why? One of the messages in this surah is materialism. Is it not? The man with the garden, right? One of the messages is to believe in the unseen, which is the story of the people of the cave, which is something they deny. And also, one of the things here is about the man who he believes in his physical resources more than Allah. And he says, I do not think the day of judgment will come. Again, empiricism. So what you find is rejection, which I spoke about, materialism and empiricism. All three of these things are denied explicitly in this surah. Because this surah, when we're supposed to recite it in protection for the Dajjalic worldview, for Dajjal, it's the meaning. It's not just the sounds, it's the meaning. And the meaning is, interestingly enough, what the new atheist movement is actually priming the world towards.